In this video, we present a demo of our technology for characterizing the emission properties of a non-omnidirectional acoustic source. The demo is based on a distributed microphone network consisting of seven triplet microphones located on the walls of this room in a surrounding fashion. The technique is based on the idea that thanks to the room reverberation, the generalized cross correlation computed at a given microphone pair is related to the amount of energy irradiated by the source in the direction toward the microphone pair. In other words, the GCC fat amplitude at the time lag associated to the source is higher for those microphone pairs frontal to the source. While moving away from the frontal direction, the amplitude is reduced with the trend that is related to the emission properties of the source. As a consequence, having a distributed microphone network available, we can accumulate GCC fat observation and over time and use the resulting distribution to characterize the emission properties of the source. The demo works in two steps. First, the position and orientation of the source are estimated using the traditional acoustic maps, and then the GCC fat observation are aligned and accumulated in an angular distribution. Now, to show how the demo works, we use this loudspeaker emitting white noise to simulate our acoustic source and move it around in this room. Notice how the GCC fat observation are accumulated in the angular distribution. Once enough observation have been collected, we can compute an average radiation pattern, the red line in the window, that characterizes the source radiation properties. Now we repeat the experiment, rotating the loudspeaker upward toward the ceiling in order to simulate a less omnidirectional source, so we can see how we can estimate a different radiation pattern for the source. Now we can calculate again the average angular distribution of the GCC fat observation, and we see that with respect to the previous case, now the red line is closer to a circle. So in this way we can distinguish between the two different sources.